What is the density of water? The density of liquid water at 4 degrees Celsius and standard atmospheric pressure is basically 1 gram per milliliter, or about 0.9998395 grams per milliliter, if you want to be technical about it. Solid water, also known as ice, is 0.9167 grams per milliliter. If that's all you wanted to know, have a nice day. Oh, you stuck around. The density of a substance varies with temperature and pressure. This is true in the case of water. Water is actually densest at approximately 4 degrees Celsius. This is when it is 1 gram per milliliter. When water transitions to a solid, its density then decreases almost 9% to 0.9167 grams per milliliter. Water is unusual because its density decreases when it is in a solid state. That's why ice floats. As the temperature of the liquid water increases, its density decreases slightly. We can actually plot this on a graph. When water reaches 100 degrees Celsius, it has a density of 0.95865 grams per milliliter. That's a difference of 0.04 of a gram per milliliter. This phenomenon is known as thermal expansion. While this difference is small, we can actually see it in a really simple demonstration. I have one jar of water that I've cooled to near 4 degrees Celsius, and here I have water heated as high as I can safely handle, around 45 degrees Celsius. I've added color for visual reference in these two jars. I carefully flip over and place the hot water on top of the cold water jar, and then remove the divider. If you were to just pour the water into the container, the water will rapidly mix and reach equilibrium, making it hard to see the difference on a small scale. Once that's done, you can actually see the water separate itself into a gradient based on density. This small difference in density allows the hot water to sit on top of the cold water. If I remove the top jar, I can actually measure the temperature difference with my instant read thermometer. The top layer is 20 degrees higher than the bottom layer. This small difference in density is really important for aquatic life. In a lake or ocean, when water cools to 4 degrees Celsius, it sinks. Any water that freezes will float onto the surface. This helps insulate the water below. This is also why a swimming pool will feel colder on the deepest end of the pool. As water cools, it will sink to the bottom of the container, and the hot water will stay on top. This is because the least dense substance cannot press past a more tightly packed substance. This is what we see here in the demonstration. There is another observable difference between the hot and cold water. When the dye is added to the different jars, the dye in the coldest jar mixes slowly, while the dye in the hot water rapidly mixes into a homogeneous mixture. This simple observation is a good way of seeing the motion of the molecules in the substance. The faster the molecules move, the more the molecules spread out. And that is the density of water. I hope that helped. Thanks for watching.